Damn, y'all. Did y'all just see what I saw? Like, look, and I know my TV is not deceiving me because I got a brand new TV. It's a flat screen. It's not one of them analog TVs where you got to put, you know, the antenna on it. It fixes to see it a certain way. I know I saw what I saw. Luka Doncic just gamed the Clippers like that. He just got them boys up out of there. But what is so puzzling to me, what I'm trying to figure out is, why two of the best perimeter defenders in the league not guarding him? Why the two best perimeter defenders in the league, none of them is checking him? Why they not guarding him on that last possession? I'm trying to figure out, what is going on, Clippers? Why y'all not out there guarding that man, Kawhi? Why is you switching so quick? Why y'all is switching off that man so quick? What is going on in Orlando, brothers? What is happening? I'm really trying to figure this out, y'all. Like, why the hell is the two best perimeter defenders in the league not checking Luka? Come on, fam. Luka nasty with it, fam. Like, I don't all respect to Luka Doncic. Luka is the truth. Like, the boy is that deal, and there's no way around it. I don't care what nobody say, fam. I don't care what you heard or nothing. In this man's second year, fam, a man averaged 28 a game in his second season? That is lethal. But what's really lethal is in a playoff game without his second best player, without Kristaps Porzingis, my man secured them the W against the what people feel like is the favorite to win the championship, because a lot of people got the Clippers a favorite, right? He got them a W over them boys, right? And he had 43 points, 18 to 31 from the field, 17 boards, and 13 assists. Brother, the man got an all-around game. But what I'm trying to figure out is everybody was saying Kawhi and Paul George, they just like Mike and Scotty with the perimeter defense. They just like them individuals. Why they not checking that man? It's puzzling to figure out. Like, I promise y'all, it's puzzling to figure out. And really what I want to know too, y'all, but what I really want y'all to see, even though it's not none of my business, I shouldn't even be telling y'all this. I don't know why I'm telling y'all this. It's really not none of my business, but I'm still going to tell y'all because y'all listening, right? Did y'all see on the second to last possession, the Clippers, the last possession that the Clippers had, y'all saw that Kawhi went and passed the ball off in such a pivotal situation? Did y'all see that? Did y'all see how that man gave the ball up in such a pivotal situation and somebody else hit the shot for them to get the lead? Now look, it was a great basketball play. It was the right play to make. But what I'm trying to see, what I'm trying to tell y'all is, a number 23 for the other LA team, if he would have passed the ball off in that situation and somebody else, a role player, would have hit a big shot, oh my God, it would have been that, it would have been like, oh, that player saved LeBron James Bacon. Ooh, and I said his name. I said the other 23 in LA. But yeah, it would have been that other player saved LeBron James' butt. He saved LeBron James' legacy. If that role player would have hit the shot, right? It would have been crazy. If they would have won the shot off that, it would have been like, oh, you know, the role player saved the day, not LeBron. But when it's Kawhi, it's the great basketball decision. All I want y'all to see is the hypocrisy. And, you know, when you compare these two individuals, right? And let LeBron James not have took that, not would have not guarded Luka on that last play and switched off. Oh my Lord, Jesus. Gee, it would have been World War III. But I'm going to make it World War III today. Because what the hell is going on? Doc Rivers is a great defensive coach. Tell him, boy, to stay with that man no matter where he go. Don't switch off. Left little Reggie on that island like that to get slaughtered like that, fam. Man, the boy looking like one of them people, one of the kids on the Hunger Games out there on that island getting slaughtered. Come on, y'all know Reggie can't fool with him and left him out there to get murked like that? Damn, what's going on? Somebody tell me what's going on. Somebody let me know what's happening so I can, like, just relay this information correctly. And again, it's really, really not none of my business to be telling y'all this. I don't know why I'm telling y'all this again. It ain't none of my damn business. But y'all know Playoff P? Playoff P? Playoff Paul George? Y'all know what that man shot today? 3 of 14, 1 of 7 from 3? In 48 minutes, brother, what is it, 45 minutes? The man had shot 3 of 14 and had 9 points to finish the game. Playoff P, where are you at, brother? Now, you talking all that cash, all that laughing you was doing with Dane, talking crazy to Dane, talking reckless out of his mouth, talking crazy. And look at this performance you got. These last couple of games been real, real shaky. And look, he's a great player. Don't get me wrong. Paul George is a great player. He's a phenomenal player to watch. Right, but everybody, you know, Playoff P, they Playoff P, he talking crazy. You can't be out here with them type of performances when you talking crazy like that. Next game, he better have 30. Next game, he better have 30. Next game, if he like, look, 9 points, 3 or 14, brother. Come on. And I remember, because everybody was like, oh my God, Playoff P, that's LeBron James. I saw people saying that's LeBron James, kryptonite, Playoff P ain't playing with him. I remember, I think it was LeBron, I don't know what year that was, the last time they played Indiana, I believe. One of the last times they played Indiana, when LeBron was in Cleveland. Did y'all know Paul George had finished the game? Or I don't know if it was the last series of the series, but the year before that. Paul George finished the game against LeBron James with like 7 points and fouled out the game? Playoff P? What is going on? The man shot 3 of 14 today, and again, that's not none of my business. I don't know why I'm telling y'all that, right? But I'm just saying, why the two best perimeter defenders in the league not on Luka? What is going on? That boy Luka lethal, and I'm not going to lie to y'all. I'm like, you know, his game, that all like offensively, his package kind of remind me of one LeBron James, how he all around gifted, rebounding, assists, scoring. You know what I'm saying? He can give you some of this, give you some of that. You know what I mean? Now, defensively, no, because a young LeBron, I don't care what nobody say, a young LeBron James used to sit down on defense. A young, athletic, spry LeBron James used to sit down on defense. I watched it consistently. And I remember when Marc Gasol won Defensive Player of the Year, when LeBron was in Miami, LeBron Poe was supposed to get that Defensive Player of the Year. But, you know, again, I don't know why I'm saying that. You know what I mean? And I know y'all going to get mad. They're going to call me a LeBron stan, a super fan. Y'all going to talk crazy about it. I don't care. Talk crazy how you want to. And look, I'm going to talk crazy. And when I'm talking crazy like this, LeBron then better win this next game while I'm talking crazy like this. But it ain't going to stop me from talking crazy because I saw what I saw. And I know my TV is new and I know ain't nothing wrong with it. And I saw them lead that. They left Reggie on that man. Mama, that goes that man. They let him get murked like that, brother. What the switching off so fast? Y'all, no, stay with him. You got to check him. Guard him. You know what I'm saying? Kawapo's we going through, fight through the screens. Come, we stay there with that man. Oh no, he murking dude them all night. They putting Lou Williams on him. I seen it throughout the series. He in there working Lou. Man, look, that boy Luka is for real. He that deal, bang bang, in Mike Green voice. But look, hey, Clippers is tied up. The series tied up now without Kristaps Porzingis, without his best player. Is 100, the score was 135 to 133. Let's see what the Clippers do next game. But all I'm saying is I saw what I saw and y'all saw it too. Machiavelli Meals TV, I'm out. Peace.